Yes, Ruchit, good afternoon. What's your view on the Nifty? You think markets have given you a strong signal to believe that the recent downfall was a false move?
Yes, very good afternoon, Pankaj. Pankaj, overall, we have seen that in last four trading sessions when the correction was there, most of the correction was from the mid-cap space. And index-wise, it has absorbed that corrective move very quite well. And also the 20 days exponential moving average, which we have been talking about even in the past, that on every corrective moves that has been acted as a support. Again, markets took support near the 20 EMA and has resumed the uptrend today. So this is just a continuation of the uptrend after that after the end of the corrective move. And we believe that markets are now headed higher towards 9600 to 9630, which is 127% retracement of the previous corrective move seen on the weekly charts. So one should definitely trade with positive bias even from current levels for another 130 points of up move in Nifty.
Right. Any view on Dish TV?
Well, recently the stock has corrected significantly in last few trading sessions. And even if we see today, the correction has been backed by very good volumes. So that is not at all a positive sign for the stock. Earlier, whatever the up move was there in the last 4 months, That entire up move has been corrected in a time frame of 15 to 20 trading sessions itself. So I think this is purely a downtrend in Dish TV, which is likely to continue going ahead. Now, on any kind of pullback moves, 92 would become a stiff resistance, which was earlier a support. So one should not do any kind of bottom fishing in such stocks, which have corrected back by very good volumes over here.
Right. Ashok Leyland has just declared numbers. Any view on that name?
Yes, we have seen that in last 1 month, the stock has took support near 79-80 range almost thrice. And from three times from that 79 to 80, the stock has seen a bounce back. So I think that has now become a very strong base. The resistance for this is seen around 89 rupees. So it would be crucial to see that whether the follow-up move comes in tomorrow's trading session beyond 89. If it manages to cross 89 levels tomorrow, then I think this up move could get extended up to 95-96 kind of levels, which was the earlier resistances. So one can trade with positive biasness in this. Just a follow-up move is required in tomorrow's trading session above 89 to confirm that that this up move could get extended up to 95.
Right. In terms of Bharat Financial, any view? That's up 10% today.
Of late, we have seen that this stock has seen a lot of volatility. Even when the stock was correcting, the correction itself was very sharp. So I think, definitely when such mid-cap stocks correct sharply, then the bounce back moves also usually is a V-shaped recovery. Now going ahead, I think 770 would be a very stiff resistance for this stock. Definitely today the stock has also given a gap up opening, which is a positive sign, and on corrections now this gap has become a strong support level. So as of now, the range for this stock would be 770 to 680 on the low side. Once it moves beyond this range, then only I believe that a directional move could be seen in the direction of the breakout.
Right, but this will continue to be volatile?
Yes, this volatility would continue, Pankaj, because even on the down moves, the volumes were there, and now when the stock is coming up, even volumes are quite good enough in today's trading sessions also. So whenever usually volumes are there in both legs of the move, when on corrective moves or as well as on the up moves, the stock tends to be very volatile. So I think going ahead also, this volatility would continue in this stock.
Right. ICICI, what would be a call? Do you think it has broken important levels on the higher side? It can go up further?
As earlier also we spoke that the stock had already given a breakout of a consolidation phase in the first week of May. And post that, we have not seen any significant corrective move coming in this stock. So this is just a continuation of uptrend which we have been seeing on the higher side. 324, 325 kind of levels should be seen in next couple of trading sessions itself. Also within the banking space, if you notice, then this has been one of the outperformers within the private sector banks. So yes, the trend continues to remain positive, and 324, 325 should be seen in next 2 to 3 trading sessions itself.
Just to clarify, when Ruchit says that it has been an outperformer, it's been outperformer in the near term. But over a longer period of time, if you would have pulled up a chart, I'm sure that this would have been one of the underperforming names in the banking space. Ruchit, does that mean names like Yes Bank, HDFC, or maybe an IndusInd Bank would start to underperform now from here on, or even they are looking positive?
See, one needs to do comparative analysis within the banking names. Yes Bank has seen a good corrective move in last few trading sessions. You rightly said that I meant to say that ICICI Bank has been an outperformer in the near term. Post the breakout in last couple of weeks, if you observe, then Yes Bank has seen corrective, whereas ICICI Bank has moved higher. IndusInd Bank is more of or less sideways only. Even Kotak Bank is one of the other private sector heavyweight which has shown a good momentum and has shown a time-wise correction whenever corrections are there. So I think these names which have not shown decent correction in last couple of weeks where the strength is there in spite of the markets were going down, those names would continue to show strength. Pullback moves could be there in Yes Bank too, but I won't say that would outperform these names. I think the strength would continue to remain with names such as ICICI Bank and Kotak Bank.
Right. In terms of names like Havells, any sort of view on that name or maybe the entire consumer durable pack?
I think Havells also, we have seen that a good correction has been seen in the stock. The broader degree charts, if you see weekly or the monthly charts, then the trend is up. And usually whenever in an uptrend such corrective moves come, those are your buying opportunities. We keep on saying that when the stocks are moving higher top, higher bottom, then buy on corrections. And when such corrections comes and stocks come near the support, that should be used as a buying opportunity. 440, 435 is a strong support range for the stock where 89 EMA on the daily chart is placed. In near term, we are expecting a pullback move up to 482 levels, which could be seen along with the market move, which we are expecting on the upside. So we should see 481, 482 kind of levels in the stock in next few days.
Right. What will be your call on Lupin?
Well, firstly, the entire pharma space has been one of the underperformer in last few months. And as of now, we are not seeing any kind of reversal coming in any of the pharma names. So we would wait for some kind of reversal signs to come in. Even we have seen in today's trading session, Lupin, when the stock has corrected. In fact, last two trading sessions, the volumes are also quite good. Now, on the longer term charts, the support is coming around 1,080, 1,100 kind of range. No doubt the stock is quite the stock is not that far from that support levels, but still I would wait for some kind of reversal comes in. Unless there is any reversal sign, one should definitely stay away from this entire space as of now.
Right, Ruchit, just request you to stay on. Markets are about to close. I'll just come back to you after that. 139 points higher for the Nifty. Sensex about 400 points higher. That's the closing bell for you. Let's just look at the levels. 9,500. That's where the provisional closing is. But at 3 p.m., we are about 9,500 and I don't think we've gone below that. So I think the adjusted close should be in and around 9,500. Sensex for you is up 1.4%. Bank Nifty is closing at a record high. So that's also doing pretty well. Let's look at what's happening as far as names are concerned on the on the gaining side. So that's the top gainer for you. L&T. Monday is when they would be declaring numbers. L&T is up about 4.8%, 80 rupees higher for L&T. Bank of Baroda is up close to 3%, 181, 182 for Bank of Baroda. Again, a very, very strong move for this name. ICICI Bank is up close to 3.5%, 316 for ICICI Bank, 38 million shares traded. IndusInd Bank did very well, 3% higher. ACC again started to move up. You have HDFC Bank, which is going up. Eicher Motors is up 2.7%. Names like Infosys, names like SBI, names like TCS were also among gainers. So you had even the likes of technology, which was not participating so far, participating well. In terms of some losers, pharma as a pack did not do well. So Lupin was down 7%. 1140 for Lupin, 88 rupees. Dr. Reddy's 3.7% decline, 93.94 rupees. Cipla was down 2.8%, 15 to 16 odd rupees. And Sun Pharma down about 1.5% to about 2%. So that's as far as the top pharma losers are concerned. These were among the top losers. Pharma continues to be on the lower side. Let's look at some losers some of the gainers on the mid-cap side as well. So Syntex, of course, after XD merger and the first opening, it did very well from the opening price. 25.26 as far as Syntex is concerned. You had Jain Irrigation, which was up close to 13-odd%, 97.98 for Jain Irrigation. India Cements did very well, 6-odd% higher. Bharat Financial Inclusion, after days of being lower, 9.5% to about 10-odd% decline, 734 for Bharat Financial. Advanced Enzyme, it went up because of the split that happened. So 8% higher, 402 for Advanced Enzyme, that did very well. You had sugar stocks, named like Shakti Sugars, names like Ugar Sugars did particularly well. So all the sugar companies also did very, very well today. That's essentially what happened in the mid-cap space. In terms of mid-cap losing space, Dish TV was down 10%, 81 rupees for Dish TV. Power Finance was down close to 3%, so that was down around 3%, 141. Lupin down close to 7%, 1140 for Lupin. Dr. Reddy's, we saw it in the large cap space as well, was slightly on the lower side as well. So that's also a name that went down today. Ruchit, we just spoke about Lupin, but in the entire pharma pack now, do you believe buying would not come so easily?
Yes, Pankaj, I think the way these stocks have corrected in last 2-3 trading sessions, even if the stocks give a bounce back, that the first of all, that would be just only because of short covering moves, if any kind of bounce comes. Usually, whenever we see that entire sector is in a downtrend, then before buying coming in, these stocks should go into a consolidation phase wherein a slow and steady accumulation could be seen. There are no signs that a V-shaped recovery would come soon, and I don't see any reason why there should be a V-shaped recovery if any kind of bounce back also comes. So bounce backs would be due to short covering and not due to genuine buying. For buying to take place in this space, I think a long consolidation phase is needed, at least of 3 to 4 months, wherein I think then if it forms higher top, higher bottom structure, then only we can conclude that yes, the buying is coming in this space. So as of now, there is no positive view in this stock in spite of the recent correction.
Right. Can you just tell us that, when you see such amount of selling, it tells you that outperforming sector is now unlikely to outperform? That's what this recent selling has told you?
What happens, Pankaj, even we have seen in the past, whenever big corrective moves are there, usually in the market, if the market correction is, if the index is correcting, then most of the sectors would generally tend to correct along with the index. But when we see that the index is in an uptrend and a particular sector is in a downtrend or the particular sector is correcting, traders or investors don't like to stay with the stocks or with the sector which has been going down. To beat the market or to beat the benchmark indexes, it is very necessary to stay with the stocks which are in an uptrend and those who are outperforming the market, rather than bottom fishing those sectors which are underperforming. So that's the prime reason that I don't think that buying would come in this sector, in the pharma sector as of now. Those sectors which are outperforming the markets, we have seen the Bank Nifty had taken the leadership in the recent past.